Hidden within the southeastern lushness of Andhra Pradesh in India, and only 100 kilometers or so up into the hills, there lies a valley whose beauty is rarely known, but which is heralded and appreciated by all who come within the embrace of its charm and unspoiled freshness. Home, since the first history of time, to the original inhabitants of the subcontinent, the Adivasis live to the rhythm of the seasons and the simple cadences of the generations who've gone before. The insidious fingers of modernity have, thankfully, only reached slowly into the quiet of these open, richly farmed spaces, where the habits and customs of tradition still hold sway, and the brash technology of progress crawls only slowly into its peace. For some years now, Nandi, an NGO dedicated to helping these simple people master the needs of their integration as a functional element within the country's economy, has focused on developing methods by which a self-sustained growth may be created for them. Within this context, Nandi has implemented methods and systems that helps the Adivasis to rationalize the ownership and exploitation of their lands and natural resources, facilitating their collectivization and ownership of agricultural and forestry acres into communal holdings on which they're taught to grow sustainable crops. One such focus has been on the development of coffee plantations in an area of India that once, with the past encouragement by the local state government, had already produced beans, but which production, through the rapacity of the moneylenders, had been allowed to fragment and become disparate in both quality and quantity. Nandi's focus in this area has been on two levels. The first revolved around the creation of a manufacturing facility on the outskirts of Araku, to which beans are brought in from various mandals and districts within the accessible areas all around, in order to produce a generic blend whose commercialization generates profits that are reverted back directly to the Adivasis.
There is no route and there is no communication, and these middlemen, they are going and they are exploiting even 25 rupees per kg. So here they are getting 120, 196 rupees. So they are happy with that.
The second, which also forms an important part of our story, has been in encouraging certain individual farmers to pick, grow and process their beans themselves, and through various tightly conceived protocols, to enable the creation of qualitative harvests whose traceability is absolute and whose end taste is without equal. Meet Bizoy. His story, whilst typical of a few farmers whose production has been exemplary, thanks to the careful supervision at all levels of the Nandi team, Bizoy's life has changed exponentially as a result of his own and his wife's efforts. From the moment that the beans are carefully picked in the plantations by his family and relatives, who've been instructed in how to pre-select only the ripest of berries, every effort has been made by the Nandi advisors to share the standards and expectations for the production of a top-end product.
Paila di lokikara
The passage of time is marked by the needs of his pre-production. His wife brings the day's collection down from the hills, and together they pre-select those beans that are guaranteed to be ripe and acceptable for the production process. It's a time for them to be together and catch up. And there's always time to sit with his family around an open fire in the yard, to join in a song with his brother. And then in the peace of the evening, and to the sounds of the crickets in the neighboring fields, to sit comfortably together and introspect quietly on their future plans, of which, though simple in scope, are legion in their imagination. As they talk, it's easy to sense the closeness of the bond that's between them. She is his partner, as much in marriage as due to the fact that she is actively involved in looking after the accounts and holding the record book in which are recorded the payments made for their crop deliveries. Indeed, it's been a strong issue for Nandi that the benefits of this newfound, guided path to an increased wealth for all of the producers within their purview should be carefully promoted, husbanded, and fructified through the common activities of both members of the husband and wife team.
Okay, Amma, you just choose one day, post one day, and my double stay, manch pole thendi, anam sepananda. Okay, just put it.
In this way, there's been a positive social spin-off by which family ties have been strengthened and many men weaned away from the destructive effects of alcoholism as a result of either buying and indulging in the local moonshine or of succumbing to the dubious delights of an intoxicating tree-fermented toddy. The advice and help given to him by the Nandi agents over the last couple of years has allowed Bizoy to increase both his wealth and his standard of living. The qualities of Bizoy's production have sold well, and whilst his wife proudly looks after all of the daily chores in front of their newly and recently built house, with all the benefits of freshly installed electricity, or walks with her daughter-in-law down to the river to fetch the water in the still traditional manner, sashaying an elegance and grace that always surprises, Bizoy enjoys the newfound freedom of his motorbike, of which he's justifiably proud. Happily enthroned in the saddle of this carefully polished machine, Bizoy may now more readily visit his friends, cover the 7 kilometers of dirt tracks down to the market in Araku, or come to check up on his current production drying down at the CPU,